Hello friends, welcome to lesson 16 on batch script. In this lesson, we will talk about decision making in batch script. If you guys haven't checked my previous video on batch scripting, I will highly recommend you guys to go and check that out. The link will be in the description. So let's start off. Decision making structure requires the programmer specify one or more conditions to be evaluated or tested by the program, along with a statement or statements to be executed if the condition is determined to be true, and optionally other statements to be executed if the condition is determined to be false. The very first decision making statement is the if statement, and with if statement we will check the variables and stick variables. So the general form for this statement will be if condition do something. The general working form of this statement is that if first a condition is evaluated in the if statement, and if the condition is true, then it will execute the statement. And one of the common use for this if statement in the batch script is for checking variables. So let me show you how to do that. @ echo off to stop the echoing, pause to hold the screen, remark check variable. So let's create a variable /a numeric to hold a numeric value, a equal to 5, set /a b equal to 10, set /a c equal to addition of a and b. Okay, so here the value of c will be 15. So let's write the if condition: if c is equal to 15, then execute the statement, the value of c is 15, and if the value of c is equivalent to 10, then print the value of c is 10. Save the file, create a bat executable file. Okay, so what right now the value of c is 15. So this statement here, c is equivalent to 15, then what will happen in this case? This statement will be printed at the output. But when we will come to this statement here, it says, is c equivalent to 10? No, that's not true. So in this case, this value won't get printed at the output. So the output of this program should be the value of c is 15. So let's see that. Here you can see the value of c is 15. So that was about checking variable. Let's do with the string variable. Tweak a little bit here. Let's just check string variable. Let's use the string string, string one, and let's say string two. Let's say a, let's say b is equal to string 1, and b is equal to, let's say, string 2. The value of a is correct and the value of b is correct. Save that. So what will happen in this case? Same with the check variable. Here the value of a is string 1. Is string 1 equivalent to string 1? Yes, the value of a is correct. So that will be printed at the output. And for b, it will see that string 2 is equivalent to string 2. Yes, then the value of b is correct will be printed at the output. So in this case, both the values will be printed at the output. So let's see that. You can say the value of a is correct and the value of b is correct. So both values have been printed. So one more thing with the if statement is that they are case sensitive. So let's modify something. If I change capital G to small g, so what will happen in this case? A is equivalent to string 1, that's wrong. So in this case, what will happen? The value of A is correct will not be printed at the output. So, and with the B, you can see we have not modified anything here. So this will be printed at the output. So the output of this should be the value of B is correct. And you can see the value of B is correct. So the if statements are case sensitive. That's important point to note. Now that was all for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. In the next video, we will talk about if else statement in batch script. Till then, stay tuned, stay connected, and thanks for watching the video.